So the harp is really the motor of the composition. It establishes the momentum for the rest of the instruments to kind of play off of. So I had the rest of the orchestra oscillate in tempo around the harp to stretch time and stretch space in a way, and have the music feel like cascading ocean-like waves where the entrance and exit of each player is slightly off rather than perfectly coordinated. So music, math, and science, like, they're all the same to me. Like, I named the song Fermion because fermions are the building blocks of everyday matter, right? Protons, electrons, neutrons, they're all kind of fermions. They make up everything you see around us, like the humans and the animals and nature, like all this stuff. We value all this stuff so much, right? We may even fall in love with some of this matter. But the individual fermion doesn't care, nor do we care about it. I doubt it's conscious or anything or has feelings. But compounded, these fermions create the physical world around us, all the humans, all the nature, all the animals, etc. Music takes us one step further into the emotional universe around us. It acts as this conduit for all this matter, the humans and animals and nature, to interact and to build communities and meaning and reasons to live and reasons to love together. So just as the fermions compound into matter, the pizzicato strings, the harp, then the double bass, the clarinet, the strings, the French horns, they all compound into a feeling which is greater and deeper than the sum of its parts. So music kind of always reminds me of how we assign meaning and fall in love with the circumstantial and kind of arbitrary offspring of space and time and matter. And I know a lot of people tend to compartmentalize, this is art, this is science. They're kind of mutually exclusive from one another, and the principles don't necessarily cross over between the fields. But I believe that there exists a unity of knowledge in the universe, and inspiration can come from anywhere. So Fermion was my first attempt to really push the symphony to experiment with space and time. So I suggest the following. Close your eyes, listen to the entire 4-minute composition with headphones, and just let go of all your thoughts and immerse yourself in the music. And then afterwards, take a moment and reevaluate your perception of space and time. And I hope that the compounding sequences of the song draw you in and immerse you, just as the beauty around us tries to do every day.